others they call it a coalition, while others they call it while EFF they call it a government of national unity, while EFF calls it a coalition. In fact, they even put it very nicely and say a grand coalition between the DA and the ANC. Well, in a statement that was released by EFF, speaking about the announcement of the cabinet by U Ramaphosa, they reacted to that by saying EFF statement on the announcement of the ANC and DA grand coalition cabinet by Cyril Ramaphosa. Right? They said the Economic Freedom Fighters, EFF, have noted the announcement by Cyril Ramaphosa of what is essentially an ANC and a DA cabinet, confirming our long-standing view that the Government of National Unity, GNU, was nothing but a smokescreen for the ANC to secure a predetermined grand coalition with the racist DA. At this moment, I will ask you a very friendly question. Do you even disagree with who's this person, with EFF, when they call it a grand coalition? Look at U Ramaphosa, for instance. He said, we're not going to work with a troublesome party. Calling the other political parties a troublesome party. We're not going to work with the troublesome parties. We will only work with the other political parties that are good, in other words. So when you count anything good, you include DA. That's exactly how Ramaphosa sees things. He included ETA in this as a political party that is good. So when EFF comes and tells you that this is a grand coalition, do you even disagree with ETA? You will remember vividly that the coalition between, look at this thing that you are seeing now, it was agreed, if you have done your research, it was agreed. When was it? It was agreed on December, this coalition. Whatever happened right now, they were just acting. And also, it was because of the public outcry. Well, speaking about public outcry, I've never seen a person agreeing with ETE, look, agreeing with what is this thing? I've never seen a person agreeing with the government of national confusion, the announcement of the cabinet. A lot of people are just denouncing, slamming it and saying this is not going to serve people. You know what I'm saying? When having seen things, what's your standing? Right. While you still think about your standing, take a look at what you need to do here. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. EFF continued and saying, it is even more concerning that the cabinet has been increased and bloated, signaling more pressure on taxpayers to allow for the accommodation of racists and their policies in high position of power. The announcement of Ramaphosa confirms that the ANC has abandoned its historical role as a liberation movement in Africa and has solidified its role as an instrument of white supremacy and the domestic and global capital on the continent by gifting the DA six ministerial post and 6 deputy ministerial roles on top of the position of deputy speaker of parliament, the ANC has suppressed compromise they made in 1994. Here. Why? I keep asking this question. Were there no better option? Or maybe we don't see the bigger picture. What's the bigger picture to begin with? Actually, one of the things that we should be asking is, what's the mandate? What are you trying to achieve? Because this thing of saying, a person is achieving, we will achieve greater results. What are you actually talking about? That's one of the questions that people don't ask. What are you actually talking about? In this YouTube channel, we know what we're talking about. But again, let's continue reading the last paragraph of the letter from the EFF. It says, these positions means that the racists opposed to implement regressive and neoliberal policies that will enrich the market fundamentalism and profit maximization by the corporate and the financial sector at the expense of poor black majority at a policy level. It is inexcusable to give racist control and influence in sectors such as agriculture, trade, finance, education, energy, infrastructure development, when they have exhibited that they govern, they prioritize the interest of white monopoly. Well, we spoke about the issues of Cape Town. I elaborated that in Cape Town, racism is still the thing of a day, even as of now. The rest of the so-called GNU members have been rendered a glorified spectators who legitimize the pact the ANC has entered into with the racist and the mandated political agenda, which comes from the Oppenheimers and the Rupert. The EFF is therefore vindicated in its decision to not form a part of the self-juniorization these parties have subjected themselves to, where a political party of a white capitalist establishment provide over their descent into insignificance. Huh. You know, there's one party that hasn't reacted to this. It's MK, but I've not seen their letter. Probably it's still coming. I'm interested to see how are they going to write. Listen to EFF. The EFF alone cautioned that the massive investment by the Oppenheimer's families in the organization such as the DAIFP was to capture South African democratic project and subvert the marginal gains made since 1994. This subversion has came through the distorting of the political arena in SA through funding and is now came in full circle. I'm sure they were sitting there saying, Ramaphosa is our guy. He's going to make things happen. And yeah, he has made things happen. Their guy has made things happen. The EFF remains the fighting and the leading force against capitalism, racism, corruption, and poverty in South Africa. And we will lead the birth of a new revolution since the former liberation now sits firmly in the oppressor's camp. Hey! EFF, my daughter, they are coming very hard on Ramaphosa and his friends. They are like, we're not going to play with you. We remain effective opposition whose sole responsibility will be to undermine the backward policy advancement of the ANC and the DA Grand Coalition. At all level of government and local picket lines, our collective responsibilities as revolutionaries remains a look, a fight for economic freedom in our lifetime. Report of the masses of our people that the former liberation movement has betrayed its historical mission and morphed into a weapon of racism. Let us build a strong, principled, revolutionary alternative towards true liberation. It's not, look, it's not, look, it's not a retreat, no surrender, as we confront racists and their lip dogs. Arr! The EFF. Pow, 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 pow. I don't even have to add my commentary there.